at this hour. David Lee Miller just arrived on the ground for us in Libya, and he joins us now live on the phone. David Lee.
Good morning. I'm in the city of Tobruk, which is about an hour's drive from the Egyptian border. And just a few moments ago, a high-ranking military intelligence officer held a news conference here. The officer held a news conference saying that he was no longer going to support the regime of Muammar Gaddafi, and he said that our duty now is to defend the people. He then went on to say and urged that President Obama intervene here and stop the atrocities of Muammar Gaddafi, and he then cautioned, saying that if President Obama did not take action, the Libyan people would retaliate in their own way by destroying the oil fields here so that Western countries would not get access to the oil. Also happening today, more anti-government forces tightening the noose around Muammar Gaddafi. There are still strong supporters of the Gaddafi regime in Tripoli, but the anti-government forces here continue to gain momentum. It seems increasingly like it's only a matter of time until the regime falls. We talked to someone with a human rights organization here, and they did say that the death count now is conservatively at 300. Others put it at 2 or 3 times that as this conflict continues to rage. Back to you.
David, you say other forces. Is there a sense that the protesters slash demonstrators are organized, even though evidently they're so different?
The demonstrators are very organized, especially in the city where I am now, in Tobruk. And interestingly, the military here, for the most part, did not flee. The security forces stayed here and joined the people. And this city is up and running today. Even the banks are open. And if you were to drive around Tobruk as we did, you wouldn't know that anything was wrong. It's very interesting to see that increasingly the military is changing sides here. And Gaddafi is having to resort to the use of these foreign militias, mainly coming from the Sudan and Niger and Chad, to try and continue to prop up his regime, and the violence and the atrocities only seem to escalate as he becomes increasingly desperate.
What about your own personal safety, David Lee? I mean, obviously, we all know what happened to some of the journalists in Egypt.
Well, we're proceeding with a great deal of caution here right now. I have to tell you that the residents of the city of Tobruk could not be more pleased to see Western journalists. They want, especially television, to tell the story about what happened here, especially during the last 40 years of the Gaddafi regime. There are people walking up to me with cell phone video to show me the street battles that raged. But the government here has frozen the internet. The phone lines don't reach outside the country. You need to have a satellite telephone. And sharing that information right now with an audience beyond Libya's borders is extremely, extremely difficult. Trying to get this videotape to you is what we're in the midst of now trying to accomplish.
Wow, that would be great. David Lee, we'll check in with you again. Glad you're on the ground. Glad you could tell the story.